the flawless vision of Nani Purush Dada Shri.
A gente vai então continuar com o livro Flawless Vision, a visão impecável de Dada Shri. And, I don't have the book here, okay?
And so we begin with the three mantra, and before even the three mantra, we offer our highest namaskars to the Paramatma, the Absolute Ones, within each one of us who are present here in this satsang.
Então, a gente vai começar com o Trimantra, mas antes do Trimantra, o Sudantão reverencia o Paramatma de cada um que está aqui na satsang de hoje.
All right, so let us, we will have the Trimantra, which will be followed by, so let's start with one person singing the Trimantra. Who would like to sing the Trimantra?
Gostaria de cantar o Trimantra?
You can just raise your hands.
Vou levantar a mão que ele vai liberar o áudio.
Yes, so Virginia, let's go ahead and have you sing the Trimantra.
Ok. Namo Vidragai, Namo Hariyangara, Namo Siddhana, Namo Vayariyara, Namo Vasayana, Namo Loyetabhasana, Esu Pampanacharam, Sarvapapanadano, Mangalam Namo Vidragai. Namo Mariyanta, Namo Siddharam, Namo Hayariyaram, Namo Vazayanam, Namo Loyesabhasam, Eso Pancha Namukaro, Tavapavapanasana, Mangalanam Chasavesim, Padamanhavai Mangala. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevai, Om Namah Shivai, Jai Satchidanand. Namo Vidragai, Namo Harihanta, Namo Siddharam, Namo Hayariyaram, Namo Upasayanam, Namo Loyestavasana. Esso pancha namukaro, tavapavapanajano, mangalanam chasavesim, padamanhavai mangalam. Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya, om namah shivaya, jai satchidanand.
Beautiful. Thank you very much. And yes. I'd like to take just each one of you, that's about three volunteers, three of you, not counting Virginia. recite one sentence of their Charanvedi, one that they like very much. Just three times. Huh?
O Suda agora pediu três voluntários para falar uma frase preferida do Charanvedi.
So let us start with Berna.
Começar pela Berna.
Que nenhum ser vivo deste mundo seja ferido, mesmo no menor grau, por esta mente, fala o corpo.
Uh-huh. Say it three times, please.
Fala três vezes, por favor, Berna.
Que nenhum ser vivo deste mundo seja ferido, mesmo no menor grau, por esta mente, fala o corpo.
What
que
is...
Nenhum... Uh-huh. Que nenhum ser vivo deste mundo seja ferido, mesmo no menor grau, por esta mente, fala o corpo.
Well, now, what did she say? What did she say?
She's saying that she doesn't want to, I'm going to say roughly, okay? She doesn't want to hurt anybody with her speech.
Okay. So she's, this is from the Pratavidhi, right? The first, yes. The early morning Vidhi. All right. Okay, so let us take the next volunteer, next one, whoever would like to. All right, that's.
Marlos.
So let's just take Marlos. Marlos.
Concede a energia absoluta para servir a esta salvação. Permita que cada ser vivo no universo alcance paz e felicidade. Permita que todos os seres vivos alcancem a libertação da alma. Poxa. Conceda-me energia absoluta para servir a esta salvação. Permita que cada ser vivo no universo alcance a paz e felicidade. Permita que todos os seres vivos alcancem a libertação da alma. Poxa. Conceda-me energia absoluta para servir a esta salvação. Permita que cada ser vivo no universo alcance paz e felicidade. Permita que todos os seres vivos alcancem a libertação da alma. Moksha.
Very good. Now, what did she say?
She's saying that everybody, roughly again, everybody to be happy and everybody to attain moksha. Isso está onde no Charanvedi, com relativo e alma, Lucinha?
É.
This is for the relative and the self.
Página 10.
But where is...
Samatha, Vivi, Rashanu, Kalyan, Karo, Anei, Kalyan, Karvani, Manei, Paran, Shatyapu.
Okay, great. Yeah, ninth column. Mm-hmm. Almost like the ninth column. Hmm? Yes. Ninth column. Okay, now let us go to the next one.
Próximo, quem gostaria?
Eu.
Ok, Elizabeth.
Com exceção da experiência exclusiva da alma pura, que eu não tenha desejo por qualquer coisa transitória ou temporária desse mundo. Com exceção da experiência exclusiva da alma pura, que eu não tenha desejo por qualquer coisa transitória ou temporária desse mundo. Com exceção da experiência exclusiva da alma pura, que eu não tenha desejo por qualquer coisa transitória ou temporária desse mundo.
Very good. Very nice. Yes. Uh-huh. Yes, our dear. So again from the Pratavidhi, early morning Vidhi. Pratavidhi and. And thank you, Elizabeth. This is, and the Gujarati was very beautifully recited by our dear Adriana.
Agradeceu a todos. Obrigada.
All right. See, when you have to ask for the energies from someone else, when you have to ask the energies from someone else, then you have to, you are at the mercy of the, that other person. You see, you are it's you're not truly independent when you have to ask the energies from someone else. Hmm?
Não é totalmente independente.
But when the energies are being asked from you yourself, you say you yourself.
Mas quando você pede energia para você mesmo,
then the energies are there and will express. There is no external evidence needed for the expression of those energies.
Hmm? As energias estão lá, não tem nada externo que vai revelar essa energia para vocês.
It is an illusion. It is a wrong belief. It is ignorance. Illusion.
É uma ilusão, é uma crença.
Wrong belief or ignorance. Okay. Bruno, you know, I'm writing this in English. You just write this in the chat in Portuguese. Okay, Bruno? Go ahead and do that. When it is an illusion, wrong belief, or ignorance to believe that I am anything else except this pure energy. You see?
É uma ilusão, ou uma crença errônea, uma ignorância, você acreditar que você é alguma coisa além dessa energia.
Yeah. You see, by believing, when you feel weak, when you feel overwhelmed by kashas, you see, all sorts of disturbances, it may seem as if you have lost your energies, but those energies are instantly there for you the moment you come back to the awareness of the kashas and not the sufferer of the kashas, you see?
Então, quando você se sente fraco com todos os kashas que chegam até você e acabam emanando, é importante você lembrar que essa energia está dentro de você.
So therefore, to be aware of the kasha is not to suffer the kasha, you see? Kasha, this is very important, okay?
Estar consciente do kasha significa que você não sofre por ele.
So when Marluz says, "Oh my Lord, give me the absolute energy," you see? That energy is yours only, but and therefore it is much more easier for you to have as opposed to you asking for that energy within from someone else, you see? Hmm?
Então, quando a Marluce pede energia, é mais fácil para ela pedir energia por ela do que pedir para alguém.
Yeah, even when you go in front of a symbol, you know, just a symbol of God, whether it is this, or whether it is any, regardless of who you believe your God to be, the energies are really coming from inside you only. You see? When you go and pray sincerely in the church, the energies are coming from inside you. They are not coming from outside you.
E quando você vai para algum ser religioso, né, que represente alguma religião, e você faz isso, ou qualquer outro tipo de movimento que represente ele, essa energia, é importante lembrar que essa energia, ela já está aí dentro de você.
Yes, but what happens is that when you ask for an energy from someone, that energy is of a different nature because of the asking. You see, you're asking from God gave me. But as opposed to when you ask from yourself, you see, this asking from yourself is only possible when you have become the source, you see. Asking from the self.
É diferente quando você pede a energia para você ou quando você pede energia para uma fonte externa, né? Porque essa energia ela está dentro de você.
It is associated with increased experience of the source, you see, increased experience of the source, you see.
É uma experiência que vai aumentar através dessa fonte que está dentro de você.
You see? Supposing there is a fight, a fight breaks out. Say a fight breaks out between three or four people, verbal fight. One person says this, another person says this, another person explodes. All of during that time, if you observe carefully, you will find one person amidst that group who will be calm. And that person who is calm is very close to the source, is not the source, but is close to the source, you see?
Imagina uma situação onde as pessoas estão brigando uma com a outra. Se você observar com cuidado, você vai perceber que aquela pessoa que está mais tranquila nessa briga, essa é a pessoa que está mais próxima da fonte. Não é que ela está na fonte, mas ela é a pessoa que está mais próxima.
And the source exists as you and I know, exists within all human beings, you see, within all human beings, you see.
E essa fonte, ela existe em todos os seres vivos.
You and I already know of sense situations which were very painful because of verbal explosions within a close family, you see. Four or five, they have all gathered together to have some good time, but sparks fly and pretty soon there is fire and pretty soon people are disturbed, okay?
Às vezes as famílias se reúnem para ter alguns bons momentos, mas palavras duras acabam saindo e acaba criando uma perturbação na família,
yeah.
Né?
Yeah, and when this happens, you and I are also aware, even before the Gnanvidhi, where there was somebody whom we called wise, the wise one, you see, the wise and patient one, you see, whether it could be a grandmother or a grandpa, you see, or somebody who doesn't say much, but when that person says something, everybody listens, you see. Everybody will say, oh, no, she's saying something, so let us not disturb, let us not say anything more, you see. Everybody, he has a calming effect on everyone, you see.
E geralmente, existe sempre uma pessoa mais sábia, com uma sabedoria maior na família, e geralmente é o avô ou a avó, que no momento desses, ela vai falar palavras com muita sabedoria para ajudar a resolver essa questão.
Mm-hmm. And yes, so it is really from the source. That is why it is so beautiful. You know, the amazement is, what is the amaze? What do you mean? What? I am asking for the energies from my own self? What? I am asking for these energies from my own self only.
So that wise person...
No, I'm talking about now Mahatmas, because you see, the wise person does not. The wise person is close to the source. He is not the source. You see, being close to the source is like...
Yes.
But, and,
yeah, okay. So, então, quando o Shuddha falou dessa pessoa mais sábia, ela não tem o Gnanvidhi, ainda não passou pelo Gnanvidhi. Então, ela só é sábia, mas ela está perto da fonte. Ao passo que nós, Mahatmas, quando a gente vira e pede essa energia, acho que quando a gente já está na fonte, é muito mais fácil.
And not only that, this is the other thing. What? I'm asking from my own self? You see, generally, whenever you ask something, you're asking from someone higher than you, from an external energy that is more powerful than you, etc., etc. But now the biggest amazement, we are all entering into a dimension of amazing world, you see? An amazing world, you see?
E a parte linda de tudo isso é que antes a gente tinha que pedir energia ou ajuda para uma fonte externa, para um chefe, para alguém mais forte que a gente. E hoje a gente vira para dentro de nós e você fala, nossa, mas eu estou pedindo energia para mim mesmo, né? Então você está aqui pedindo essa energia para você mesmo.
Yeah, and then the other one is very interesting, where he says, what? The biggest amazement is, what? I am doing namaskar. I am doing namaskar to my own self. To my own self, I'm doing namaskar. I had learned how to do and revere and pay my respects to everyone else, others. But I never, now I learned that the final namaskar is to my own self. My own self, no one else, my own self. See?
A gente aprendeu muito a reverenciar algo externo, né? Então, para nós, é uma grande descoberta, é maravilhoso saber que a gente pode fazer a última reverência realmente é para o nosso ser, para o nosso próprio ser. É muito bonito.
Yes, but you see, this is the thing. The Lord Mahavir has said, there is no one but you. You are the final station, you see?
You... O Lord Mahavira fala, não há ninguém a não ser você. Esta é a última estação.
You're the final station. All the trains come to you. They don't go anywhere from you. This is, you know, all the trains come and you are the final station there. I see. Now there is nowhere to go for you except to rise and accept and rise in this understanding that there is no one else. You see?
Então você, o ser, com V maiúsculo, está na última estação, né? E é muito bom você saber que a reverência é realmente para você, o seu ser.
Yes. And therefore, once you know that I am the one, then everything in front of you, whether it is likes or dislikes, desires, likes and dislikes, you see, or desires and denials, you see, desires and denials are all this, all situations and circumstances and have got nothing to do with me, you see.
E outra coisa também é que agora que você é o ser, você começa a perceber que gostar, desgostar, desejos, negar, a negação, tudo são situações ou circunstâncias e você continua como um ser.
Yeah, why? If there is a desire that the world considers bad, if there is a desire that the world considers bad, why does it upset me? You see? If it, I am aware that it is circumstantial in nature, situational in nature, and it is dependent on an external happening that is not I, you see?
Então, quando no mundo a gente entende que desejo é uma coisa ruim, né? Então, quando a gente tem algum desejo relativo, a gente fica chateado. Por que que eu fico chateado? Mas você, o ser, você sabe, o paciente, que aquilo é uma circunstância, que aquilo é um evento específico, que não tem nada a ver com você.
Yeah, so you see, this ultimate understanding arises. And this is the vision that this is the vision which we call absolute vision. You see, absolute vision, absolute.
Quando esse entendimento ele se solidifica em você, isso é chamado de absolute vision.
Yes, and this is the absolute vision, otherwise known as Keval Darshan. You see, Keval Darshan.
Chamado de visão absoluta, que é o Keval Darshan.
You cannot. A Keval Darshan is absolute vision is not something that you can play with. In other words, it's not something that you go in and out of. If either you have it or you don't have it, and it has for us all in this Gnan Vidhi, my dear friends in Brazil, for us all it has begun, you see, and it continues regardless of what Bruno is doing or what Virginia is doing, etc. See, the absolute vision cannot change anymore. It is absolute.
Então, esse Keval Darshan não é algo que a gente pode entrar e sair quando quiser. Uma vez que você entra nesse caminho, depois do Gnan Vidhi, ele é um caminho que ele continua caminhando. Então, o Bruno pode estar fazendo qualquer outra coisa na vida dele, mas essa evolução, ela continua acontecendo.
There is no energy on this earth. There is no force on this earth that can take vision away from you and I anymore, isn't it?
Não existe força suficiente nesse mundo que possa remover o que está achando da gente.
And with that vision, all faults fall away like dust on your clothes. You see, if this shirt is dirty, if I walked in a dusty area where there is a lot of dust, all I have to do is to take it out and like dust it, you see, and the dust will fall away in the same way. With the absolute vision that you and I have, all of this is simply dust that falls away, and there is nothing to be guilty about, there is nothing to be sad about or sorry about. This is only, it only requires one stroke, you see? Uh-huh. One stroke and it's over.
E essa visão, ela é tão forte, e você pode fazer assim como se fosse tirar o pó, sabe? E toda essa tristeza, arrependimento, qualquer coisa que você esteja sentindo, se você fizer isso, vai embora.
You see, and the ignorance falls away. It's like just one stroke. In other words, one entry into the self through any one of these five, and immediately the dust falls away, you see. Dust of ignorance. Mm-hmm.
Say it again, Shuddha.
One stroke means, remember we said, you take the shirt and you just hit it, you know, you bang it against a hard surface and the dust will fall away, you see? In the same way, one stroke of coming into this vision of any one of these five agnas is the same as making one stroke, you see, for the ignorance to fall away. Hmm?
Então, o Shuddha está dizendo assim, que uma pincelada de qualquer uma das cinco agnas representa essa força que eu estava falando, de pegar esse pó que é representado pela tristeza, arrependimento, qualquer outro sentimento, e cinco agnas.
Yeah, this shirt is a covering, however, this body too is nothing but a shirt, you see. Yes, the body too is a shirt that covers the soul, you see, covers us, you see. This body too covers us. It's just and we've had countless, infinite number of body coverings in previous lives, you see.
Essa roupa que a gente está usando, ela está cobrindo o corpo, que está cobrindo a nossa alma. E existiram milhares de corpos antes que cobriam a nossa alma.
Yeah. You see, we respect this body, this current body, we have reverence for it, because it is in this body that we have attained this magnificent God, or this Lord, or the Self, you see. This is the body in which we realize the Self, you see. That is why we have, of all the previous bodies that we've had, this is the most precious one, most revered one. We should revere it.
Então, o Frida está dizendo que é importante a gente reverenciar o nosso corpo, né? Porque foi através dele que nós atingimos o ser, conquistamos o ser, através do Gnanvidhi.
Yes, we revere it because it gave, it allowed us, it cooperated with us so that it, we could be let out of our prison, you see. We were in a prison of a sort and we are out of the prison, you see.
Porque agora a gente está longe daquela prisão que a gente estava antes, né?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You see this, and so how do we revere this body? Then, you know, we, how, what is the way to revere this body? Then the answer is very simple. We stop abusing it. We do not abuse it, you see. We make gentle use of it now, just like a wise old man or woman would do. You know, it would treat it with reverence and respect, you see. Not abuse it, you see.
E como que a gente agora reverencia esse corpo, né? É como se a gente fosse uma pessoa idosa e sábia que cuida do corpo, do nosso corpo, e trata bem dele, e não exagera.
Uh-huh. Yeah, no, we also let it become natural. In other words, if it's hungry, you give it some food. If it is sleepy, put it to bed. Allow it to go to bed, you see. If it is
também de reverenciar esse corpo é permitir que ele siga o curso dele. Se ele está com sono, ele vai dormir. Se ele está com fome, ele vai comer.
Yeah.
Deixa ele.
If it is hurting somewhere, you say, okay, let me help you with it. Let me massage it for you, or let me, you know, this. It's as if you treat, you know, now you treat it with awareness, you see. You become more aware of it, you see. When you treat it nicely, it will treat you nicely too.
E agora, você trata esse corpo com consciência. Porque quando você trata ele bem, você vai receber também o bem através dele.
Yeah, and because of the load and the stock that it has filled in the last life in it, if it does, through it, something negative happens or painful happens or shameful happens. Negative, painful or shameful. Negative, painful or shameful, okay?
Por causa do estoque de karma, se algo negativo, dolorido ou vergonhoso acontece, desculpa.
You see, when it happens in your light, you know, you forgive it. Don't get too upset about it, you see. Don't blame it, you see. Forgive it, let it go, you know. You know that it is not the body that is doing it.
Então, de novo, quando algo negativo ou dolorido ou que causa vergonha aconteça, cuide do corpo e diga a ele, eu sei que não é culpa sua, né? Não foi você que não é você que está criando isso. Seja agradável com o seu corpo.
And likewise, if something positive, you see, bless, helpful and respected, you see, respected by others, you see, happens through it, you see, by others through it, you do not become too excited about it. Be aware of it and, you know, encourage it. Encourage it and say, okay, good, if it's helping others, go on, but don't get too excited about it, you see. Don't become the owner of when it does good things. Do not become the owner.
Então, quando coisas positivas ou que estão ajudando ou respeitosas aos outros acontecem, Não fique, você pode até talvez não fique excitado com o corpo, só encoraje-o e diga para ele assim: se vocês estão fazendo alguma coisa para o bem dos outros, continue.
So, David, so you see, by adopting, by being in the mode of equanimity towards the body, you help the body the most. You see, you are when by not being moved by the faults of the body or the virtue of the body, you remain in equanimity. You see.
Então, quando você não se apega às coisas boas ou ruins que o corpo está fazendo, você consegue permanecer num estado de equanimidade com o seu corpo.
And by and this, and the more you remain unmoved and in perfect balance, the more natural this body will become. The more natural, you see, this body will become. It will be, you see, the self is natural, Atma, soul is natural, and the body will also become natural.
E quanto mais equilibrado você estiver com relação a este corpo, melhor será para você, porque o ser, ele é equilibrado, a alma também é equilibrada, né? Então falta equilibrar também a questão do corpo.
Okay, so Shudatma Bhagavan, let us move. I'm going to share the screen so that we can move and be with Dada as we read more about his flawless vision.
Vamos agora continuar a leitura do Flawless Vision, tá? Da versão impecável.
All right, and let me just share the screen here. And we are... Let me see. Do you know which page? A conviction of a... No.
Alguém sabe aonde a gente parou? Lorines, você sabe?
All right. Do you know which page we are? Highest spiritual effects. We have done that already.
I know. Just a minute. I'm looking for it.
Okay. Thank you.
Obrigada. Você tá aí. Eu cheguei pouquinho atrasada, mas...
Okay. We did the science impeded by acquisition in page...
Just a minute.
69.
Maybe...
Yeah, now I think it's intellect, right? It has got...
Satsangs. It was me last week.
Yeah, right. And I
yeah.
It is this one we read. We read this one. You read Science Impeded by Accusation, right?
Yes.
Okay, so now... Denise, we come to this one, Intellect, the Expert Fault Finder.
Okay. I'll just check if it is true, but you can go on, okay?
All right. Yeah. It's a very small paragraph, so let us read, and I will read in English, Ridrena, and then you go ahead and read the...
Yes.
All right. Intellect is the expert fault finder. Absolutely no one in this world is at fault. The fact that you see faults at all is your illusion. Do you understand this? Dada is asking us all, do you understand this? Maybe a little, do you understand this? If you see anyone's fault, that it is your illusion, do you understand this somewhat? And the questioner says, I understand some of it. And so the other, she says, no one is at fault. It is your intellect that relentlessly shows you the fault of others. That is why the world continues on and on. The intellect is an expert at looking at other people's faults. Such a person will say, that man has done wrong. That man is the one who did it wrong. If you were to ask this person to talk about his own faults, he will tell you that he has very few faults. Both of these responses are of the intellect. The first response and the second response, both are of the intellect. All right, go on. Yeah.
Então, intelecto, o especialista em descobrir falhas. Absolutamente ninguém neste mundo tem culpa. O fato de que você vê falhas em tudo, é a sua ilusão. Você entende um pouco disso? O questionador responde, eu entendo um pouco. Ok, can, you can go down, please.
Mm-hmm, sure.
Então, Badashiri responde, ninguém tem culpa. É o seu intelecto que implacavelmente mostra os defeitos dos outros. É por isso que o mundo continua. O intelecto é um especialista em olhar para as falhas de outras pessoas. Essa pessoa vai dizer, esse homem fez isso errado. Se você fosse pedir para esta pessoa falar sobre suas próprias falhas, ela iria dizer-lhe que ela tem muito poucas falhas. Ambas essas respostas são do intelecto.
Okay, I just want to check something here, all right, okay. Yes, this is, this, and we'll come back to it, and I'll re-share this again. There's one point that is worth noting here, and that is the, that is, it is, this can be improved. When the other says no one is at fault, this next sentence, it is your intellect that relentlessly shows you the faults of others. Dadashri hasn't used those exact words. Dadashri says, Dadashri says that it is the, not your, Dadashri says it is the intellect within. It is not your intellect, but it is the intellect inside or within that relentlessly shows the faults. Does shows the faults of, it doesn't show you the faults of others. It just shows the faults of others, you see. The intellect inside relentlessly shows the faults of others. If you are showing it, if it was showing you the faults of others, you might be able to correct it. But you see, that's not the issue. Okay, let's you translate that and then...
Tá. Então, aqui na frase, quando a Dashiri fala não, é o intelecto que faz com que você veja as faltas nos outros. Não é bem assim. Na realidade, é o próprio intelecto que faz encontrar as falhas, não é a gente que encontra, entendeu? É o intelecto que está lá dentro trabalhando o tempo todo.
Right.
Eu falei certo.
Yeah, so the Dadashri has used, let me improve the sentence even more because it's important. It is the intellect inside that shows, that continuously shows the negative and the wrong. You see?
Então, é o intelecto aqui dentro da gente que faz com que a gente veja coisas erradas.
Yeah, it's,
não sou eu que vejo, é o intelecto. Como se o intelecto tivesse um olhinho e vendo, entendeu?
It's kind of very interesting. It's not that it, its role is to show, it continuously points out to the negative and the wrong only. What's wrong with what is happening outside or around you? It is the exact role of the intellect to keep on focusing or showing that only, see?
Uh-huh. Então, o intelecto, ele fica continuamente mostrando pra gente, apontando pra gente o negativo, o errado. É o intelecto que faz isso.
Shows the wrong and the negative, you see, and when you do not have any other light, a person does not have any other light, then this, he or she is at the mercy of the light only, and whatever the intellect shows, they immediately agree, you see, and that is where the ego agrees, you see, the ego agrees, ah, yes, she's like this, and he's like that, and they are like that, you see?
E quando não há nenhuma luz interna que possa te ajudar, qualquer coisa que o intelecto mostrar de negativo, de errado, o ego vai endossar. Realmente é isso.
You see, so, and therefore, it is not only to see the wrong and the negative, but also the first thing is to see the wrong and the negative, and then secondly, to blame that person as the one who is doing it. So to blame the other person as the owner of the wrong and the negative, you see?
E não é só, o intelecto não só vê e aponta o erro e o negativo, mas ele também começa a culpar a pessoa. Ele trata a pessoa como fazedora.
Now you see, this is so interesting, because you and I always know very negative people. All of us are aware of some negative person or the other. Negative in the sense that the moment they come to your home, or moment you are in their company, they begin with the negative. They begin with complaints. They are always finding faults, all right? Now, we learned a very new thing here today, that it is the light inside her that is showing her this. That is her light.
É muito interessante, né? Porque a gente sabe que quando tem alguém perto da gente que é muito negativo, que ela começa a falar, reclamar, encontrar muitas falhas, a verdade é que a luz dentro dela é muito fraca, então ela começa a olhar só pro negativo.
Yeah, the science, the Dadashri is giving us the exact scientific understanding of what is happening by when you are in front of a person who is very negative or always finding faults. Dada is saying to all of us, you and I, that that is the result of the light that he or she has. You see?
Dada fala muito sobre isso. Toda vez que a gente está na frente de uma pessoa negativa, que só fica encontrando falhas nas outras pessoas, é que ela tem uma luz muito fraquinha.
Yeah, if a person who is wearing very thick glasses, eyeglasses, very thick ones, okay? Mm-hmm. Can't find the glasses and therefore kind of upset something that was on your table and breaks it, would you not say that it is because she couldn't see, you see, properly? You couldn't see properly. If she had put on the glasses, then she would have said, yeah, I don't want to touch this and I don't want to touch this, things like that, you see. So she does not have enough light. She doesn't have the right vision, you see, the right vision.
É como se a pessoa usasse um óculos muito grosso. E sem os óculos, ela não consegue enxergar as coisas corretamente como elas estão acontecendo. E a analogia é, então, ela não tem muita luz interna para poder perceber as coisas como elas estão acontecendo.
And so, just like there is wrong vision, there is also right vision. If a person does not have to have the gnanvidhi to stop seeing faults of others, you see. His intellect can be trained, is it, from the wrong use of intellect, wrong light, to right light, you see?
So you're saying that wrong right vision and right vision can be trained regardless if you think enough?
Right vision. That's called right intellect, wrong intellect, you see? So the role of the right vision and wrong vision with a small v is the result of right intellect and wrong intellect, you see? So intellect, there are people with good intellect too. They don't do this kind of stuff, you see? They are not enlightened, but they don't see faults of others, you see?
Então, o intelecto ruim e o intelecto bom faz com que a gente tenha uma visão ruim e uma visão boa. Né? E desde eu estiver errada, me corrija. Mas eu entendi ele falando que não necessariamente, às vezes, a pessoa pode ter até um intelecto bom. Ela pode ser treinada para ter um intelecto bom, mesmo sem ter nada.
Yeah, now this is helpful to a certain extent. You see, this is when the intellect does become better if it is trained in the company of right circumstances, you know, good people, caring people. A child that grows in an atmosphere of caring and good people with the right kind of education has an intellect that does not hurt others, you see, as opposed to a child that does not have all of this, you see.
Então, o intelecto, ele acaba ficando melhor na companhia de boas circunstâncias. Por exemplo, uma boa educação, ou uma criança que vive num ambiente onde ela vê que as pessoas não são respeitosas uma com a outra, ela entende que ela também tem que ser respeitosa. Então, o intelecto pode ser treinado.
And so the intellect, therefore, is under the influence of social circumstances, you see. You know, if you're in Brazil, you are more likely to be less, let's see, where is the sound coming? Okay, if you're in Brazil, you're less likely to be violent with reference to bombs and, you know, distant wars, as opposed to if you are in the Middle East, you see.
Então, o intelecto, ele realmente ele é influenciado pelo que ele tá, pelo ambiente que ele está vivendo, né? Então, se você está em Brasília, você vai viver situações diferentes, tá em São Paulo serão outras completamente diferentes, e o intelecto, ele é influenciado por isso, ele acaba sendo treinado também através disso.
So, Brazil versus Middle East, okay? There's a difference, because a child growing up in Brazil will not be exposed to such violence, as opposed to a child in Syria or wherever.
Então, uma criança que mora no Brasil versus uma criança que mora na Síria, por exemplo, ela é tremendamente influenciada pelo ambiente que ela está, pela circunstância que ela está vivendo.
Yes, but we are going above, beyond, we are going rising above the right intellect and the wrong intellect. In this sentence of Dada, saying that it is the intellect that shows the negative and the wrong, and that is why this whole life after life problems continue. You say life after life after life. If there is one thing that Dada has caught the exact culprit, the exact guilty one, which is the intellect. You see.
E nós, né, nós, Mahatmas, a gente está acima do intelecto certo e errado. Mas o Dada Shri fala no livro, e é essa frase que o Shuddha está reforçando tanto, que é o intelecto que interpreta o que é certo e errado. Mas isso é importante, ele tem falado muito sobre isso e reforçado.
And furthermore, with reference to what Adriana read, you see, this is not his fault. I mean, you know, he is such a person, and this is the rest of the world. They are very quick to find faults with everyone else and find faults with them. But when we ask them, can you please show me your fault? They are simply not able to do so. They'll say, I have one or two faults. And that too is science, you see. That is, they're not trying to hide it. That too is pure science, you see.
E então, essa frase do Dada fala muito sobre isso, né? De que a gente aponta muitos erros nos outros, mas na hora que a gente pergunta, mas e aí, quais são os seus erros? A gente consegue falar dois ou três, mas não vem muito além.
Why? É uma ciência. Yeah, because why is it a science? Because he has the only light available in his name. His name may be John, and he believes I am John, and he has no other awareness, you see. He has no other awareness, and so whatever his intellect shows him, that is his light, and his ego agrees 100%, you see.
E por que que é uma ciência? Porque ele tem uma luz limitada ali. Então, o que que acontece? Quando você pergunta quem você é, ele responde, eu sou John. O intelecto vê só isso, o intelecto interpreta só isso, e aí o ego vai e endossa o que o intelecto está afirmando.
Okay, so let us take a break and we'll come back. Shall we take a break and we come back?
Um intervalinho. Cinco minutos?
Yeah, it's how many?
5 minutes.
Okay, all right. So we'll be back in 5 minutes, all right?
All right.
só consegui entrar agora, Adriana. Desculpa, foi de
Não tem problema, não. Eu só achei estranho, mas o Bruno entrou ali e o Bruno começou a preencher quase também o chat. Só uma pessoa não dá mesmo, não.
Então, eu achei que o Bruno... Eu não vi que o Bruno estava traduzindo, entrei e acho que atropelei o Bruno, fui traduzindo também o chat, coitado. Bruno, me perdoa, desculpe mesmo, continua, porque daí eu fico de backup para a Adriana, tá bom?
Uai, se você puder continuar, para mim vai ser melhor, porque eu tô aqui, eu entrei assim mais para ouvir o áudio mesmo, que eu tô fazendo as atividades aqui. E aí daqui a pouco eu tô saindo também, eu não vou poder ficar até o final não, sabe? Aí, mas se quiser que eu continuo, e eu tô no celularzinho pequenininho aqui, que demora pra ficar digitando.
Tá bom, então eu continuo. Ô Bruno, quando você vai começar a me ajudar na tradução, Bruno, do livro? A Pitavani, eu tô precisando de tradutor.
Nossa, acabei de entrar na faculdade de volta, fazendo outro curso aqui, Educação Física. Eu tô bem, vou ter a trabalhar também, tô... Acho difícil conseguir traduzir por agora, sabe? Acho que só lá para junho mesmo que eu vou conseguir voltar para a tradução.
Legal, legal. Sim, junho, julho, segundo semestre, eu puder contar com você, ia ser legal. Nem que seja um pouquinho de coisa, porque um pouquinho cada um fazendo, não precisa ser muita coisa. Ou um livro inteiro, entendeu? É, porque daí a gente tem mais gente para dividir e fica só um pouquinho mesmo para cada um. Não sobrecarrega ninguém, entendeu?
Entendi. Não, deixa eu só estabilizar um pouco aqui com essas coisas de faculdade, assim, de programação, horário de estudo, que eu preciso, tá. O tempo livre que eu vou ter, essas coisas que eu te dou uma posição para poder ajudar também.
Legal, obrigada.
Parabéns, Bruno. Tá tendo uma boa faculdade. Pois é, né? Eu tentei ser profissional de tênis, mas nesse país aqui não tem muito sentido. Aí, acabei me dando mal aí socialmente, financeiramente, mas não tem nada não. Voltando aí aos estudos.
Ah, mas você vai continuar no ramo esportivo, né? Então, tudo bem que não tem, mas parabéns pelo jeito.
Ah, obrigado, Bruno. Obrigado pelo incentivo.
Física é a tua primeira faculdade, é isso?
Não, eu quase formei psicologia, só que faltava um ano e surgiu um monte de problema aí, pessoal. Aí eu voltei pro fazer na Califórnia. Aí aqui eu fiz um semestre de psicologia, não gostei do meio aqui, de atuação, dos estudos, tudo. Aí afastei um pouco dos estudos. Aí agora que eu voltei de novo.
Você tá morando na Califórnia?
Não, eu tô morando em Goiânia agora. Eu morei lá 4 anos, mas já tem 4 anos que eu tô de volta já pra Goiânia. Agora que eu decidi voltar a estudar mesmo e tentar estabilizar um pouco aqui. Que antes eu tava meio que assim, vou pra aqui, não tá dando certo. Vou pra ali, não tá dando certo. Aí acabei ficando mesmo. Pelo menos tá com todo lado aqui do meu pai, minha mãe, essas coisas. Família e tudo. Amigo de infância.
Legal. Tomara que você ache muito bom. Às vezes demora um pouquinho pra gente achar, mas a gente fica bastante. O rumo espiritual você já achou, né, Bruno?
Agora eu tô... isso aí até ocupou demais meu tempo, até pus prioridade por um certo período da minha vida, entendeu? Aí eu deixei várias coisas assim que a sociedade aqui me cobra, a família cobra, amigo cobra, tudo demais. E agora eu tô aceitando a cobrança.
Já veio, pessoal, já veio.
Okay. So let me mute everyone and then just continue. So when we say, when this is the beauty of it, when we were not enlightened, when we did not have the light, we had no choice except to follow whatever the intellect showed us. You see, whatever the intellect showed us, that is what we accepted. Oh, sorry. Adriana, yeah, go on.
Quando nós não somos iluminados, não temos essa luz interna, a gente fica muito à mercê de qualquer coisa que o intelecto interpreta.
Now, for the and but now that we have the light of a million suns, you see, when we are the source of that light, there is the ability to see what the intellect shows. You say there is the ability to see what the intellect shows. When you meet a group of people, three or four people, and some of them are strangers, there is a good opportunity to see what the intellect shows. The intellect inside is not dead, you see. So it will show, it will make opinions about 1, 2, 3, it will show some, start showing faults, you see.
Então agora que a gente tem o sol, a gente tem a luz de milhões de sóis, a gente agora tem a fonte, né? Somos iluminados, né? A gente tem a habilidade, a gente consegue não deixar que o intelecto interprete tudo, porque a gente consegue ver o que está acontecendo. Yeah. Então a gente tem uma habilidade muito grande quando a gente está perto de 3 ou 4 pessoas, e se o pessoal...
The intellect will show faults, but by immediately being in one of the agnas, when you see the pure soul of the person, you see, the intellect will not have any force on you, because you are now using your real light, you see.
Começa a julgar, a criar opiniões sobre essas pessoas, agora ele não tem tanta força sobre você, você consegue observar o que está acontecendo.
Yeah, in the real light, you see the self in the other person, even though that person may be a braggart, you know, maybe unpleasant or obnoxious, you see.
E nessa luz agora, você consegue inclusive ver a luz do outro. E mesmo que essa pessoa seja desagradável.
Yeah, you see the self. Seeing the self in the one that you do not like is an amazing exercise. You do, Denise is smiling.
I lost you, Shuddhatma.
It's easy to see the self. It is easy to see Shuddhatma Bhagavan, you see. Also Amapura, and it's easy to see the Amapura in your brother or in your sister, you see, who is sitting next to you. But when you can see the Amapura in the person that you do not like, that is a very significant achievement, you see.
Então é fácil ver o ser, a alma pura, nas pessoas que você gosta, que você tem um bom relacionamento, na família. Mas você realmente sabe que você está iluminado quando você consegue uma pessoa que você não gosta ver a alma pura dela.
That is the test. That is the test of the 5 agnas, you see. You have to put it in.
Esse é o teste. É o teste da 5 agnas.
That is, the agnas are so beautiful. First of all, you know, if you really want to help the person who is mean to you, may not be mean to you, but, you know, sits in a group that you're sitting with, 3 or 4 people, and is mean. Mean, to others and is just painful to listen to, if you, you know, you can begin the healing by simply seeing her pure soul, you see. Simply seeing her pure soul.
Mm-hmm. E as lágrimas, elas são tão bonitas, né? Imagina que a gente estiver nesse grupo de 3 ou 4 pessoas e uma pessoa é um pé no saco para a gente ficar ouvindo, né? E na hora que você aplica as 5 lágrimas, tudo se transforma ali.
Yeah. See, what happens is, when a person is talking normally, you are not as reactive. You know, it is just ordinary conversation going on. But the moment a person starts becoming difficult, or whenever the conversation becomes heated, at that time, that is the time when your responses are needed. But generally what happens is you also get drawn into the whirlpool of the conversation. You also take sides, you see, of this person or this person. You also start the blame game. It's called the blame game.
Uh-huh. E numa conversa, geralmente todo mundo acaba se envolvendo nessa conversa e começa a acontecer aquele jogo de culpar o outro, né? Nessas conversas que ficam muito quentes.
So the intellect will make you take sides, you see. Intellect makes you partial. Intellect makes you partial. You take sides of one or the other. And prajna makes you impartial, you see.
O intelecto, numa situação dessas, atua fazendo você tomar partido de alguém. Ao passo que a prajna atua numa situação dessas, mantendo você imparcial.
And prajna is easy. Prajna does not require any energy. Just you need to be with prajna rather than you need being with the old intellect. You see? Being with the intellect is the old habit. You have to cultivate this new side, which is your side, the side of the Amapura, you see? Cultivate that. Give it energy.
Então, nós agora, a gente tem trabalhinho de cultivar, estar sempre com a prajna e cultivar menos o que era nosso hábito antigo de alimentar o intelecto, de permitir que ele tome partido de alguma coisa, né? Uma situação que eu estava mencionando.
Becoming aware that it is her intellect or his intellect that was showing them this, and that is why they spoke like that. They are pure souls. You see, they are not at fault. Even in the relative, they are not at fault because they do not have the light. How can you blame a blind man for bumping into you, you say? How would you, supposing a man bumps into you in broad daylight, collides with you, and then you look at his eyes and you find out that the poor man is blind, would not all your anger go away? All your anger will vanish, you say?
Então, a gente se torna mais consciente como o intelecto tá atuando e mostrando as coisas pra gente, né? Porque ninguém tem culpa. E essas pessoas com quem a gente se relaciona, às vezes elas também não têm essa luz que a gente tem. Então elas também não têm culpa nenhuma. Aí deu um exemplo aqui que eu me perdi um pouco.
And Dada Shri says...
O exemplo é quando...
And Dada Shri says... that this person is physically blind, but anyone who enters into Kashai, and which is the world cannot refrain from being involved in Kashais because they do not have the light, you see, and therefore they are blind. Not having the light means you are blind, you see.
Mm-hmm. E não ter essa luz interna faz com que os cachais apareçam, né? Denise wanted to tell something because I couldn't explain the previous example you mentioned.
Can okay, you just... Denise, go ahead, Denise. Should that be very easy, Denise? Yeah, go on.
Sorry. Que ele disse assim, se alguma pessoa cega tromba com você, você fica muito irado e na hora que você vira, você percebe que ela é cega, você, a sua raiva, a frustração, ela vai embora imediatamente. Você não culpa a pessoa por ser cega. É esse o exemplo que ele deu.
And this is very similar to, you know, the sentence by Lord Jesus also, which is where he says, forgive them, my Lord, because they know not what they are doing. They do not know what they are doing. They do not have the light. You see?
E semelhante a isso, quando Jesus está na cruz, se eu falar errado os nomes é porque eu não curto muito religião, e ele está lá na cruz, ele fala, perdão, Pai, porque eles não sabem o que eles estão fazendo. Ele quis dizer que eles não têm luz.
Yeah, you see, but you know, it is not even a matter of crucifixion. It's just simple arguments and things like that. If you and I can remain aware that it is not him, it is the reaction of the intellect ego complex in that person that is doing this, then you have entered into elemental science of liberation. Elemental tattva vignan, you see. Tattva vignan, which means elemental science of liberation.
E agora, nós, você e eu, conscientes, que não é ele numa situação de um desentendimento, né? Que é o complexo ego e intelecto atuando nessa situação.
Yeah. Yeah, right. You see, you and I can identify with pain signals. If somebody pinches you, it's painful. If you're hungry, there is pain in the tummy, you see, hunger pains. We can identify with these physical signals very well. But these subtle signals of kashai, these kashai reactions are very similar. They are very real. But now we are not trying to change them, we are simply becoming aware of them. You see, we are simply becoming aware of them. All right?
Então, a gente hoje consegue identificar a fome, esses sinais que acontecem no nosso corpo. E esses cachais, o ego, o intelecto, eles são muito sutis, né? E às vezes é difícil de tá percebendo.
You see, for the others, anytime the other person is very disturbed and is very painful to be around or very, very difficult, this knowledge must come in, and therefore you say, forgive them, my Lord. You can invoke the Lord inside them. You say, oh, my Lord inside them, not the Lord above, like Lord Jesus did. But, oh my Lord, you say, Lord, inside that person, forgive them. You know, you are energizing that person. The person is becoming wild and angry. And you can say, my Lord, please forgive her because she doesn't know what she is doing. And please grace her with your vision. You tell that person who is upset, the Amapura inside that person, oh my Lord, great, bless her.
E quando você tiver com alguma pessoa e ela estiver muito perturbada e começar a falar coisas desagradáveis, você pode invocar a alma pura dentro daquela pessoa. O Senhor, abençoe-a ou ajude-a para que ela possa perceber o que está acontecendo.
So there is an automatic forgiveness that is coming. You don't have to do pratikraman because you are actually connecting with the Lord inside that lady or that person who has created this, who seemingly is the reason for this disturbance, you see?
E existe nesse momento, quando você invoca a alma pura dentro daquela pessoa, existe perdão automático acontecendo ali, porque você sabe que não é ela, né?
And by invoking the Amapura in that person, you are automatically into the state of the Amapura, you see. By seeing the Amapura, you become the Amapura, you see.
E ao invocar e ver a alma pura da outra pessoa, você automaticamente também está nesse estado de alma pura.
Be yourself, you see? So we see this is both ways. It's such a direct connection. Such a direct connection that removes you first from any effects of the interaction that is off. That is disturbing and is a kashai, you see. Anything that disturbs is a kashai.
E quando você faz isso, isso remove você primeiro dessa situação. E também ajuda com relação ao kashai. Remove the kashai in us.
Yeah, I know what you're saying is, but just by this approach, you become free from kashai first, you see. Because if you get involved in the kashai, then all, you know, everything goes, you see. So you have to, this is the exact approach to the kashai. This is the exact approach to the intellect that is misguided or wrong.
Então, esse é uma estratégia muito boa que a gente pode adotar de invocar a alma pura do outro, ver a alma pura do outro, porque a gente faz com que os cachais não emerjam na gente e o intelecto tenha menos importância nas nossas interpretações. A gente fica mais no estado de alma pura.
And we see by focusing your vision on the intellect, you see, no, it is not a question of my intellect inside me or inside the other person. It is by focusing purely on this intellect, there is a very subtle way of not blaming the other person as the owner of the intellect. You see? Is this clear? Is this clear?
And when you focus your vision in the intellect.
No, you're not. No. When this exact sentence. It is the intellect inside that makes one see wrong, okay, and negative. So therefore now, when the wrong or the negative arises in front of you, you see, you are not blaming that person saying that she is doing it. Your vision is now on the intellect. It is, yes, it is inside her, but you are not saying she is doing it, you see.
A visão agora que a gente tem é que a gente percebe que aquela pessoa não está mais fazendo isso. Não é ela que está fazendo.
Então,
o intelecto.
Yeah, do you see, this is so subtle, but if we can get this in exactness, it is a major, win in our Akram Vignan understanding, you see? It's a major battle won, you see?
Let me just double check if Denise has anything to fill in. Tem alguma informação adicional que você acha que tem que colocar com relação ao que o Shuda falou, Dê?
Não, tá bom.
Não? Okay, we're good.
Yeah, you see, so it's one thing to see what is it inside that causes kashai, and then it is another thing to say that he is doing the kashais or she is doing the kashai, you see?
Not sure. Denise.
Okay, so there is okay, all right, Denise.
I didn't understand the...
This is from the owner. Okay, so let me just, I just wrote something here. You see, it is... We have come to a point where we're not talking about ourselves anymore now. Okay, we're talking about the other person who is very upset or he's negative, all right? Ordinarily, we say she...
De nós mesmos. A gente está falando de uma outra pessoa que é bem negativa.
All right. Now, by focusing on this particular sentence that Adriana read today, that it is the intellect inside that continues to show the negative and the wrong, okay?
Então, focando no parágrafo que a Adriana leu, é o intelecto que vai procurando o correto e o errado.
So it is like the woman who is quite blind without her glasses, you see, or it is the blind man who cannot see. So it is really now, therefore, the ownership is not ascribed to her, that she is the one who is negative, you see. You move you are aware of the intellect, her lack of light, but you are not saying she is being negative, you see.
Então, a gente consegue perceber a falta de luz da pessoa, mas nós não estamos dizendo que ela não tem luz.
See, before, nós... right, before, say,
é isso, né, Adriana? Just a minute. Okay,
go on.
Não é isso?
Yeah.
É isso. Agora você continua. Eu te ajudo se quiser.
Okay, Adriana. So before, a man suddenly collides with you, you're walking nicely on the road, somebody just collides with you, you know, and then you look at his eyes and you see that the poor man is blind, you see. So before he collided, you were became very angry. But the moment you know that he can't see, you are so sorry for him. So the anger turns into complete compassion and pity for him, you see?
Então, nossa situação, ele está falando de novo sobre a situação do cego, né? Que se eu colidisse com uma pessoa cega, no momento, quando eu colido com ele, eu tenho aquela sensação de raiva, mas na hora que eu olho para ele e vejo que ele é cego, aquela raiva, ela diminui e entra, eu entro num estado de compaixão pela pessoa.
Right? And this is a gross example, this is a physical example, but the same is the case with these kashais that begin around you. Whenever a kashai begins around you, you see, nobody who has come in a group wants to light the match and begin the kashai, you see, but it happens. You and I know it happens, you see, and the fact that it happens now, we get a new light in what we have read today. Yes, eh?
Então, assim, o exemplo que a gente deu anterior foi um exemplo muito grosseiro, muito físico, né? Mas a gente sabe que os cachais, eles vão emergir. E agora, nessa luz da alma pura, a gente tem uma interpretação diferente.
And know for sure, one thing very, very, very sure for our group here, that any kashai, all right, any kashai will drain away the energies of the Amapura. Will, you know, you are the Amapura, but the moment you enter into any kashais, okay, your energies will go in that direction of the kashais. So kashais, the kashai is a big consumer of human energy.
E qualquer momento que a gente entra em contato, se envolve com o kashai, ele consome muita energia da alma pura.
Yeah, all right. So now let's go on further with reading further. Shall we?
Vamos continuar a leitura, tá?
Let's share the screen. And we go to the next. This heading, which it says, always look at your own fault.
A gente vai agora para sempre olhe para a sua própria culpa.
Questioner, Dada, since no one is at fault, then it would also mean that I too am. Faultless or flawless, right? Dada Shri says, no. Why does one suffer? Suppose I were hit by a falling rock and I got hurt badly, whose fault would it be? No one's. And Dada Shri says, in such a situation, you will infer that it must be my fault and hence this has happened to me. You will have to acknowledge that indeed the fault must be yours. Unless a person can see his own mistakes, how will he make any progress? When someone curses you and you remain unaffected and you retain a constant understanding that it is the result of your own mistake and that the other person is absolutely flawless, and simultaneous pratikramans are happening or being done, then this is the highest knowledge of the Lord. This indeed will lead you to final liberation. If you follow this one sentence of mine, your liberation is guaranteed. Okay.
Interlocutor. Uma vez que ninguém é culpado, então isso significaria que eu também sou impecável? Dada Shuri. Não. Se uma rocha caiu de uma altura sobre mim e eu estou ferido, de quem seria a culpa? Interlocutor. De ninguém. Dada Shuri. Em tal situação, você vai inferir que deve ser minha culpa. E, portanto, isso aconteceu comigo. Você vai ter que reconhecer que isso é realmente sua própria culpa. A menos que uma pessoa possa ver seus próprios erros, como ela vai fazer algum progresso? Quando alguém te amaldiçoa e você permanece inalterado e você retém uma compreensão constante que é o resultado de seu próprio erro e que o outro é absolutamente impecável e pratikramãs simultâneos estão sendo feitos, então este é o maior conhecimento do Senhor. Este fato vai levar você para a libertação final. Se você seguir essa minha frase, vossa libertação está garantida. Ok.
All right. Now, this and the previous paragraph that we read are very connected. The first paragraph. Now, after knowing the intellect, now this is coming. When you say Dada says, if you say everyone is flawless in the world, then therefore I too am flawless, right? So at this stage of the game, at this stage of the science of liberation, Dada doesn't say, yes, you too are flawless, you see? Dada says, as long as you have to suffer anything in this world, as long as there is suffering in this life for you, then your flaws are still there.
I got lost, Shuddha.
Okay. All right. Okay. Let me just come back here. It started with the first question and the first answer. Dada, you say that everyone in this world is flawless. No human being is at fault at all. And therefore, I'm included in that too, no? I too am flawless, right, Dada? And Dada says, no. And here is why it is so. You are at fault as long as you still have to suffer the effects or suffer pain in life, you see. Suffer any kind of pain, that means it is your fault.
Então, na primeira pergunta que eu li, né, que é a pergunta assim, Dada, se eu não vejo todo mundo como impecável, isso significa também que eu sou impecável? E o Dada responde, não. Porque enquanto você ainda se crer, sentir alguma dor, tiver algum efeito acontecendo em você, ainda tem falhas.
Right, and you see, he does not give the example of somebody else saying something insulting to Adriana, you see? He gives a different example. He says Adriana is walking on the street and all of a sudden something falls from above and it's a piece of stone. And Adriana looks up and doesn't find anybody, and so it just fell from a height and it fell on her head, you see. So who at that time, you see, Adriana, when not finding anyone to blame, she she is brought into a different mode of understanding. Who did this? Where did this come from? Where did this come from?
O Dada dá um exemplo muito interessante, que é, imagina que você está caminhando na rua e alguma coisa bate na sua cabeça. E aí você começa a procurar, a tentar encontrar o culpado e você não acha ninguém. Então aí, e é um momento interessante porque você entra num entendimento diferente.
And Dada Shri says, who will you blame? And the man says, Adriana says, no, I can't blame anybody, it's no one's fault. I say, Adriana will say, no one's fault. Well, how can you say it's no one's fault? You are hurting. You have a little bit of blood on your head, you see. How can you say nobody's at fault? So now Dada is making Adriana herself admit no one is at fault.
Então, e aí quando o Dada pergunta para a pessoa, mas de quem é a culpa? O entendimento que a pessoa não é ninguém. Né? Então, é um entendimento diferente de que ninguém é culpado.
And let me see in what is... I will just go to, I'm going to see what's written here in English to make the correct translation there. And so Dada Shri says, in such a situation, you will infer that it is must be my fault. No, let's improve that. Dada Shri says, there you will possibly accept that it might be my fault, you see. You will not infer that it must be, because you see, it's difficult to tell Adriana, it is your fault that this fell on your head, you see.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yes, it is my fault.
Yeah, it's so you know, it's difficult. I mean, you may say yes, it's possible that it is my fault. You see, in such a situation, you will accept that it is possible that it is your fault, and therefore it happened to you. You see, but you will, and you will have to acknowledge that. Indeed, the fault must be yours. Now, this Dada has not said, he just says, when no one else is involved in this world and something happens to you, then who will you blame? So therefore, you got nobody to blame except you. You see? There is no one you can blame except you, right? It is. Do you understand? So go on.
Yes. So, então, nessa situação que eu estava falando sobre a pedra que cai e bate na cabeça da gente, nessa situação não tem ninguém ali para culpar, né? Então é o momento onde você compreende que aquilo aconteceu com você e a culpa é sua. Então e a pessoa precisa começar a ver os erros.
See, this is coming to the exact essence of this fault is of the sufferer, which is a sutra of Dada, which is the discovery of Dada that he has given us, because he it's a vision of Dada who can see much more than what you and I can see, right? You know?
É a visão de Dada que faz ver muito além daquilo que está ali na nossa frente.
But Dada is saying that no, just because I can see more than you doesn't mean that I cannot show you the exact science behind why it is your fault. And he is saying it in here. He says, it is not a question of you will have to acknowledge, but it is you will have to... Will you not have, okay, improve this sentence, and Denise is writing this, right? So, will you not have to see, instead of this sentence, you will have to acknowledge that will you not have to see where you are wrong? Will you not have to see where you are wrong? Did you get that, Denise? Right? Yeah. See, and then it says, And then he says, unless a person can see his own mistakes, how will he make any progress? This sentence is correct, but this sentence before it needs to be changed, you see. You will have to see, it's not a question of you will have to acknowledge. It's not a question of acknowledging or agreeing or accepting. Dada is not saying, I want you to accept that it is your fault. Adriana is walking, it falls on her head, the stone. Dada is not saying, accept it, that it's your fault, you see. Uhum. Yeah, that então, is... All right, go on.
Correção aqui na frase, porque a gente fala assim, né? Ah, isso aconteceu comigo e eu tenho que compreender que aconteceu e a culpa é minha. Na realidade, não é bem assim. A frase é: você precisa ver que o erro é seu.
Okay. So there were about 25 or 30 ladies walking on that street, you see?
See where you are wrong. It's a C with S, capital S, isn't it?
Well, C with a capital S is only for the time, for the one who is enlightened. But this portion of the book, NEC, as you know, is for people who, everyone, you see, we haven't come to after Gnanvidhi yet, you see. So you just leave it as a small C, you see. But you and I both know that for us, we have to see it. But even for the other person that is saying, don't you think you'll have to see? See, you know?
Maiúsculo ou V minúsculo? O Judá falou que é V minúsculo nessa situação, porque a pessoa aqui, nesse caso, não recebeu o Gnan ainda.
Ok?
Ok.
Ok.
All right, now.
All right, now.
Okay, all of a sudden, okay. Wait a minute.
All of a sudden, wait a minute.
Why am I hearing,
why
my,
am
own
I hearing my own echo?
Okay, let me cut
okay,
it down.
Let me
okay.
cut it down.
All right, okay, now it's better. Okay. All right, now continue, and I'm just going to unmute Adriana here. Now, see, this is very interesting. And Dada has given this example. Adriana is walking on the street, and there are 25, 30 people, women also walking on the street, you see, young ladies, you see. Now, and it's a crowded street, a narrow footpath, you see. But the rock that fell falls only on Adriana's head. It doesn't fall on the lady in front of her, doesn't fall on the lady onto her right side, to her left side, or behind her. And all of them are walking pretty fast. All right? How exact is this account? How exact is this account? Just think. Adriana looks up and says, ooh. Where did this come from? Can't see anyone to blame. Cannot see anyone to blame. This is the important thing. The intellect is always finding, who do I blame? I'm hurting. I want to get some. Who threw that stone? See?
Então vamos lá. A Adriana, então imagina que a Adriana está andando numa rua com 25 mulheres, todo mundo, e é uma rua muito estreita, muito cheia, né? E a pedra vem e puf, cai só na cabeça da Adriana. Não cai na cabeça de mais ninguém. Como que é exata essa conta, né? E a Adriana não consegue ver, né, o que está acontecendo. Não consegue ver culpa em ninguém. Porque ela não acha ninguém para culpar. Que isso, yeah.
And the other she says, this is exactly why I tell you, I can see it. And I see it and I speak. The other she says, I see and I speak. I see and I speak. This is so beautiful. Dada Shri says, okay? Dada Shri says.
E Dada diz, então, é por isso que eu posso dizer que eu estou vendo e eu falo.
He says that I see that if there is any suffering that comes to you, it is exactly your own effect and no one else's. Nobody can interfere in this, you see, account.
Eu vejo que ainda há sofrimento em você.
Yes.
E essa conta é só sua.
And the suffering is of both pain or pleasure, you see. So, whether, you know, when something good happens to you, something, some pleasant happens to you, that is also coming to you and your own account, and something painful happens to you, that is also coming to your own account.
Quando eu falo sofrimento, não estou querendo dizer que é só sofrimento de coisas ruins, pode ser tanto dor e prazer, né? E é uma conta única e exclusiva da Adriana, por isso que a pedra caiu na cabeça dela.
You see, so that these two paragraphs that Adriana read really are two ends of the same spectrum. On one side, this is the beginning of the flawless vision, and on the other side, the second paragraph is the end of the flawless vision. You see, beginning of the flawless vision is where you. There is an acceptance of the suffering. Yes, the acceptance of the fault as my own. You see,
acceptance. Elas falam sobre o começo do da visão impecável, que é onde eu começo a ter a aceitação de que a culpa é minha.
Supposing that, yeah, right. If there are three brothers are there in a family, and one of them works very hard, very, very hard. Say he is the middle brother, okay? He works very hard for the family to help everyone in the family. And the family, the entire family is doing very well. You see, all three brothers are doing very well because of that, okay?
Estou numa família três irmãos e um deles trabalha muito e toda a família está indo muito bem por causa disso.
And the middle brother also takes care very, very much takes care of the old father who is dying. The other two brothers are not around, you see?
E o irmão do meio cuida do pai que está morrendo e nesse momento não tem.
And then ultimately the father, the rich father, passes away, and when they open his will, the middle brother finds out that he has not been left with much money by the father, you see. Now, this is the account, you see. There is no one to blame, you see. He can see it in two ways, or he can blame the father. He can see it exactly and say, I did most of the work and yet he did not leave me any money. See? And this happens a lot in our practical life, you know.
E aí dá um exemplo aqui, que estão escondendo do meio, ele cuida do pai, e o pai acaba falecendo, né? E quando eles vão abrir o que ele deixou, para ver o que o pai tinha deixado para cada um dos filhos. Esse filho do meio percebe que o pai não deixou nada para ele. E nesse momento o filho tem um entendimento de que não é a culpa. Não é culpa de ninguém.
Yeah, in front of. It's got mistype, but it's in front of. Okay? So this is ingratitude in front of benevolence. You were being benevolent, you were being kind, and you have been slept with, and you are facing an unkind act. You see, you're facing ingratitude, isn't it? You feel like. Right, now this person, the middle brother who does not have Gnanvidhi, even if he just reads these sentences of Dada that we read today, and if he, you know, he at least understands that it is not my brothers who are at fault, that this is how my father saw it. This is how he saw it. Whatever reasons, this is how he divided it. He's gone now. And the fact that I received very little is somehow my own coming back to me, you see, my own account. That is the beginning of the flawless vision, you see.
E aí esse filho do meio, que não recebeu o Gnana, ele vai e lê essas frases, ele começa a ter um conhecimento um pouco maior, e ele começa a compreender que essa, por ele ter recebido menos dinheiro, nenhum dinheiro comparado aos irmãos, essa é a conta dele, é a conta kármica dele. E isso é o começo da visão impecável.
Right. This, yes, is the... When you do not see any other person doing this to you, when you do not see any other person giving you pain, then you have the opportunity to see where you are wrong, where you may have been wrong, you see, yourself. There's no one else to blame, you see. So at that time, the intellect inside becomes very quiet, you see, because there is no one to blame.
Então, quando você não vê ninguém lhe dando dor, prazer ou dor, você tem a oportunidade de ver as suas contas.
You see, if you are driving and you run into an accident and your car collides with the other person, it's very easy to blame everyone, all right? But when you yourself are driving and your car ends and hits a pole or, you know, curb and, you know, there's damage to the car, there's no one to blame, you see? So there is no, you don't see anyone to blame, and therefore you're very quiet, you know, you're like a sheep, you see? Mm-hmm.
Então, até mesmo um exemplo de uma batida, né? Se você bate, colide contra um outro carro, você vai procurar culpar alguém. Mas se você colide o carro contra um poste, não tem como culpar ninguém.
But the sign, não tem como culpar. But it doesn't end there. The Adashri says, will you not have to see? Will you not have to see that this is your fault? You see? Will you not have to see that there is something... Why is it that the other person did not have an accident? Why is it that you are the one who is suffering and nobody else, you see? Everybody else in the family is gone to bed and you are here, you are trying to worry about how to fix your car, etc., etc.
E aí é quando você começa a ver, né? Você pode se perguntar às vezes, por que somente eu estou sofrendo? Por que somente eu bati o carro? E aí você começa a perceber e ver que são as suas contas.
And you know, when it is this exactness that we dealt with by looking at the intellect and the role of the intellect without saying it is she who is doing it or he is doing it. We are just focusing on the limited light of the intellect. We have begun into a very beautiful new journey of liberation, you see. Beautiful new journey of liberation in worldly interactions, you see.
E a partir desse momento onde o intelecto tem uma interferência muito menor na gente, que a gente começa a ter uma interação no mundo relativo melhor.
If in daily life applications, if we can see that anything that appears wrong to you and I, if it appears wrong to us, we, by becoming aware that it is, he is not doing it, she is not doing it, but it is, that is how that person's intellect is showing him, you see. Now, therefore, you have entered into a very beautiful elemental view towards the science, you see. You're keeping everything separate, you see.
Então, a aplicação é de novo assim, uma pessoa que ainda não recebeu o Gnan, ela vai ver alguma coisa errada e o intelecto dela vai dizer, foi ela que fez, foi o outro que fez. Mas nós, a gente consegue manter essa separação, nós conseguimos manter essa separação.
Yeah, you see, so now, so that is when somebody, so the in the extreme cases, that's such a person, somebody is cursing you, somebody is openly insulting you, all right? At that time, there is no effect inside, zero effect, all right? And at the same time, you become, you feel, you, at the same time, you feel that it is my own fault. You see, my fault. The world will say it is the fault of that person to be so impolite and so rude. But you will say, no, it's my fault. And it, and the opposite person appears, you understand that the other person is flawless, okay? That, and at the same time you continue to, I'm just reading the paragraph from Gujarati here, and you, and pratikramans are happening, then you have risen into the highest knowledge of God. This, there is no higher knowledge than this. You can go. Yeah.
Supondo, vamos supor um cenário onde tem algum, alguém xingando você, né? E agora você aqui, a pessoa que já passou pelo Dhinavidhi. Não há efeito nenhum interno em você. E ao mesmo tempo, é, você também não vê mais falha no outro. E apesar do outro, é, você vê o outro como impecável. E o outro vai ter a visão dele, né? Mas você, ao mesmo tempo, está ali naquela situação, fazendo pratikraman simultâneo. Né? Então, é uma outra maneira de interagir no mundo.
Now, there is only one word that needs to be deleted here in the Gujarati, in the English translation. When a person curses you and you remain unaffected, all right, and you retain a constant understanding. No, there is not. You can't retain this understanding. It's not retaining a constant understanding. The word should not be constant, should be removed. But an understanding prevails. An understanding happens. And an understanding is there that it is a result of your own mistakes. You see, an understanding is there that it is a result. It's not a constant understanding, because the understanding is, and potan asar na thai, and you remain unaffected, and potan jatni bulche ulage, and you believe, and that it feels as if it is your mistake, and therefore the and the understanding arises that the other person is flawless. You see, forget the word absolutely flawless. The other person is flawless. Did you get that, Denise? Yeah. Okay. Good. All right. So, okay. So I'm just trying to be very exact with the words of our Dada Shri here with you.
Porque tem ali uma frase, uma questão sobre uma compreensão constante. E o Shuda pediu para ela tirar esse constante da frase.
Yeah. You see, this, until you believe that it is your mistake, until it feels as if it is your mistake only, when the other person is hurting you, it pratikramans, correct, exact pratikramans will not happen, see? You know, the other person is clearly abusing you in front of everyone, and here Dada Shri is saying you will have to come to the understanding that the person is flawless. It is your own mistake. You see, then.
Até você acreditar que isso é um erro seu, que é uma conta sua, você precisa ter um entendimento de que o outro é impecável para isso mudar.
And that whole example comes in along with this example that we gave of Adriana walking, you see, on the street, and there is no one who has injured her. No one that she can see who has injured her, you see. But then it is, the two has to be put together. Dada Shri says, these are all your own accounts coming to you. You see, that's all. Your own accounts. One where you can see a person doing it, one where you cannot see a person doing it, but the result is the same. You're the one who is suffering, you see?
Então, o exemplo da pedra que a gente passou é um exemplo, mas que na realidade, acho que a compreensão é a seguinte. Quer exista uma pessoa ou não para né, qualquer situação, a gente precisa ter o entendimento de que a culpa é nossa. And
that, yeah, absolutely. So this is, and he says, this is the thing that fault, so this paragraph really, this what we have read today is actually focusing on fault is of the sufferer, you see. And it is the entire science of fault is of the sufferer. And if this is Dada, she says, only this single sentence, if you accept it 100%, then this, even if you do not have Jnanvidhi, you will go attain moksha. Every time you suffer in life, you say, it is my own fault, not anyone else's, you will attain moksha, you will attain liberation.
E o Dada diz que se você tiver que ter uma compreensão de uma frase que te leve a moksha, mesmo que você tenha tomado Jnanvidhi ou não, é essa, que é a culpa de quem sofre. Porque isso pode te levar até moksha.
Yes, so you know, all of you have heard Adriana and Denise and our dear friend there for a while who was translating Bruno and Shuddha with so much patience and love, and for that we are very grateful. And we are grateful for your presence here.
Shuddha está agradecendo a presença de todo mundo, agradecendo a Denise, o Bruno, a Adriana por ter ajudado na tradução hoje.
And so we as we'll just very quickly look at the Paramatma, the absolute ones within each one. We just say Jai Satchidananda.
Paramatma de cada agora.
Jai Satchidananda, Jai Satchidananda. And we come to Denise, Shuddhatma Bhagwan, Jai Satchidananda.
Jai
Satchidananda. And to dear Bernard, Jai Satchidananda. Jai Satchidananda, Shuddhatma Bhagwan. And to dear Marlos. Jai Satchidananda. And we come to Virginia. Virginia.
Jai Satchidananda.
Jai Satchidananda. And we go to Elsa, Shuddhatma Bhagwan. Elsa. Jai
Satchidananda.
Jai Satchidananda. Mm-hmm. And we come to Margarita. Jai Satchidananda. Margarita, Shuddhatma Bhagwan. And to dear Elsa, Sanira. Jai Satchidananda. Jai Satchidananda. And to Elizabeth.
Jai Satchidananda.
Jai Satchidananda. Jai Satchidananda. And we come to Maria Cristina, Maria.
Jai
Satchidananda. And to dear Danilo.
Jai Satchidananda.
Jai Satchidananda. Jai Satchidananda. Jai Satchidananda. Dividada, huh? Jai
Satchidananda.
Jai Satchidananda. Yeah. And we come to Kasia. Jai Satchidananda Kasia. Shuddhatma Bhagwan. And let's see here. We have iPad of Marlene. Let's see. I don't know. Yes. Who is this? And Marlene. Yeah. Jai Satchidananda. Jai Satchidananda.
Jai Satchidananda.
Yeah. Jai Satchidananda.
Jai Satchidananda,
Shuddhatma Bhagwan. And We have Vanya. 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 Jay Sachidan Vanya. Okay. All right. So, all right. Until we meet again. Yes. We may we all remain in this beautiful vision of Dada. And it is at his feet. We say bye. Jai Sachidanand. And I will stop the recording, but you can.